What's up, everybody? It's Keefe, and you're watching Ghost Cult Magazine's 5-minute reviews, except two hands is 10. This episode features Gojira and their brand new album, Fortitude, out April 30th on Roadrunner Records. For a little backstory on Gojira, this is Gojira's first new album in 6 years, following Magma, also on Roadrunner, which was the 2016 Ghost Cult Album of the Year. The artwork for Fortitude was created by Joe, who is obviously not only a brilliant musician, but also a gifted artist as well. You can purchase the album at the link below and contribute to the Amazonia Project. For those who have been living under a rock, Gojira was formed 25 years ago in Bayonne, France, on the west coast of France. They are a progressive metal band with all kinds of groove and modern metal flourishes. They helped innovate what we consider to be modern metal today, following the footsteps of Sepultura, Pantera, Metallica, and more, headed up by the brothers Duplantier, Joe, and Mario, who now live in America, but the band is still based in France and is always very passionate about the environment and self-improvement and making humanity a better place. Not very metal to be so caring and kind, but they are. All the hallmarks of Gojira's history are present, but as we said in our review at ghostcultmag.com, written by our excellent scribe in the UK, Gary Alcock, the band continues to find new ways to express their heaviness. The album has traditional heavy metal and prog metal songs, sometimes sounding like Meshuggah or Devin Townsend. Other times they're rocking major grooves like Machine Head or classic Pantera, and always a little bit of crossover with death metal and black metal and thrash metal, all wrapped up into one with the riffs and inventive drumming by Mario Duplantier. You already know the first three songs on the album because those are the first three singles: the incredible Born for One Thing, the exceptional Amazonia, a tribute to the Amazon people and the Amazon rainforest and the need to preserve it, and Another World, which premiered last fall. Other killer tracks on the album that are super heavy and inventive include Hold On, Newfound, and Into the Storm, all excellent tracks, the final closer Grind. But there are some other things on this album that are very eye-opening and ear-opening that Gojira has never tried before. The title track Fortitude is a somewhat interlude that's followed by the song The Chant that sounds like Down or Down 2, with shades of unplugged stoner doom and psychedelic rock. The band continues to evolve and shapeshift into their final form, whatever that's going to be, but Fortitude is another banger of an album. It is excellent, goes right into the flow with all their discography, and obviously Gojira fans are going to be pleased by this, but I actually think that it's certainly not a commercial album, but it's definitely a little more accessible for the non-fan. For any fans of Gojira worried that as they get older and down the road in their career that they're somehow softening in any way or being less awesomely heavy, they are not. There's definitely a little more prog on this album than ever before, and that's saying something for this band. Shades of Devin Townsend or Tesseract or some of the more less extreme moments of Meshuggah, but still, the essence of Gojira is here. This is a fantastic, terrific album. It makes you think, it makes you feel, and it grooves all day. Fortitude is the latest in a lineage of expansive experimental albums by Gojira, where they continue to build off the sound they created over 25 years ago. Fortitude has all the things you love from Gojira: incredible grooves, fantastic singing, thought-provoking lyrics, super smart topics about the world and the planet, and also personal trials and tribulations, but as well, fantastic playing. The members of Gojira are some of the greatest musicians in the world at what they do. It is not just one guy or the brothers, it is the whole band as a unit, like a fist. To quote Gary Alcock's review, "The most varied and heterogeneous record from the band thus far. Some of the more experimental material on Fortitude is likely to be met with a certain amount of resistance, but there's still more than enough heads down, neck-breaking heaviness to please the most devoted Gojira old schooler. The vocals might be cleaner, the music more eclectic and eccentric, but for those who embrace progress, the rewards will be many." Gary Alcock of Ghost Cult. We give this album a 9 out of 10, one of our highest marks at Ghost Cult. You can read the full review at ghostcultmag.com. I'm Keefe, thanks for watching 5-minute reviews. Gojira Fortitude is out on Roadrunner Records, April 30th. We're out.